The only thing I'll say about Jungle Fantasy is, since it is a very large jazz-based piece, there's a solo in the middle of it that you are allowed to clap at the end. Here's Jungle Fantasy.
Thank you.
I am so extremely excited to present this next piece. It's exceptionally innovative and probably one of the first wing band pieces of its kind. I can't thank Dr. Taylor enough for the last 2 days and how outstanding they have been working with our students. I'm going to welcome him up to stage one more time to introduce this last piece. Let's welcome Dr. Taylor again.
Thank you. Thank you.
three of them, Dr. Chen, in a round of applause. I can't tell you how much fun it was to conduct a piece like that and to be able to sync it with the video and how enjoyable the process of a piece like that was to do. So it was an absolute blast. Our next piece is called Song for My Children by Andy Boysen Jr. An absolutely beautiful lyrical setting that Andy wrote for his five children. He originally wrote kind of a first piece for his wife called Song for Lindsay, and then quickly thereafter wrote this piece. This will incorporate the senior slideshow, and I'd like to thank Jake Henderson for putting that together. Thank you, Jake. Let's give him a round of applause. And at this point in time, I would also love for all the seniors to stand up and be recognized. Here's a song for my children. I have a handful of thank you and announcements before our last piece, but first I would like to recognize the John Philip Sousa Band Award. Introduced in 1955 to honor the top senior students in a high school band, the John Philip Sousa Band Award recognizes superior musicianship and outstanding dedication. This year I am proud to select two individuals voted upon by their peers and selected because of their dedication towards the KMHS band program. Please help me recognize Caitlin Irish and Jonathan Johnson. I'd like to congratulate the two students selected into the 2018-19 Minnesota All-State Concert Band. These students spent countless hours preparing. I'm extremely proud of them. Let's recognize Olivia Frediani and Tyler Upham. We'd like to thank Minnesota Wi-Fi and Darren Steppel for the generous continued support of the Performing Arts Center. Let's give him a round of applause. I cannot thank the KMHS staff, the administration, Brock Trinan, Mr. Matuska, Mr. Langamo, and Mrs. Braun for their extreme support of the music programs here at Kasson Mantorville. I am so thankful every day I go to work that I can go to them with very large projects. And they are helpful and outstanding in every way, shape, or form. So if we can give that a round of applause. The department would also like to thank the facilities and custodial staff for their assistance preparing for this performance. I'd like to thank Pat Moran for helping me out with all the technical aspects of this concert. A huge thank you to my band colleagues, Liz Harwood, Sarah Vincent, and Catherine Anderson for their work in the middle school preparing the high school instrumentalists of tomorrow. If we can give them a round of applause. And I can't thank my choral colleagues enough, Mr. Faller and Mrs. Yison, if we can give them a round of applause. thank you to Nancy Johnson for her work preparing all of the high school musicians. We wish Nancy the best in retirement. We're so incredibly thankful for all she has done in Kasson, Mantorville. A huge thank you to a handful of students that have helped tremendously with the band library. I think Taylor and Chris has put in a good 40 hours, if not more, organizing that and making it a very nice place. Along with Jade Sands, Manny Mishaw, Kate Treehy, and Morgan Coy, if we can recognize them. I'd like to thank the families that hosted the Luther Concert Band in March. That was a tremendous experience, and I really appreciated that. Tomorrow night at the Legion, from 5:30 to 7:30, we are having another Burger Fry, and we completely sold out all of the food at the December Burger Fry. That goes a long way to make nights like this possible and dip various expenses for the program. So if you're able to join us there, it is 5:30 to 7:30, to 5:30 to 7:30, there you go. $8 per person, all proceeds go directly towards the CAN band program. And we still need a few parents to help out for tomorrow night and a couple of students. So if you see Kathy Peterson on the way out, please check with her if you're able to help. A reminder about the Memorial Day ceremony on Monday, May 28th. And then lastly, I was able to write a grant through the Southeast Minnesota Arts Council, which is an outstanding organization. And I can't thank enough Kelly Braun and my wife and my mom, who helped so much with the grant writing. So we can give them a round of applause. Thank you, parents. Thank you so much for your support of this program and everything you've done for your students. And again, let's thank the seniors one last time. Seniors, congratulations. So it's been an ongoing, I don't know if I would call it a joke, but in everybody's pep band folder is the Memorial Day music, which includes this beautiful setting of Amazing Grace. So for the past 4 years, this specific senior class, every time we have a pep band game, and I ask for the next chart that should be played, they loudly suggest Amazing Grace. Amazing Grace. So this is the Canadian brass version of Amazing Grace that I play often with my brass quintet, arranged for concert band. And we are excited to have Dr. Taylor joining us on this. We will also feature Mary Bueller, Ben Treby, Jonathan Johnson, AJ Hawk, Jared Johnson, Colby Johnson as well. So here is Amazing Grace. Enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you.